हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग गेट 2017 एरोस्पेस इंजीनियरिंग पेपर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 34 इज ए ट्रेस फ्रॉम सिक्लोन फोटोग्राफ ऑफ द फ्लो अराउंड ए कॉर्नर रिवील्स द एजेस ऑफ द एक्सपेंशन पैन एज शोन बिलो। द लीडिंग एंड ट्रेलिंग एज ऑफ द एक्सपेंशन पैन मेक एन एंगल एज शोन। अज्यूमिंग गामा इज इक्वल टू 1.4 द एंगल ऑफ एक्सपेंशन पैन इन डिग्री इन टू डेसिमल प्लेसेस इज द प्रांटल मेयर फंक्शन इज गिवन बाय वी एम इज इक्वल टू रूट गामा प्लस वन माइनस डिवाइड बाय गामा माइनस वन। टेंजेंट इनवर्स रूट गामा माइनस वन डिवाइड बाय गामा प्लस वन एम स्क्वायर माइनस वन माइनस टेंजेंट इनवर्स एम स्क्वायर माइनस वन। So this is your angle 40 degrees, this is your 20 degree angle, this is the expansion pan angle, this is M2, this is M1, okay. So finding M1 and M2, here the M1 can you find out by this, the direction of the M1 is this and leading edge of the expansion pan is this, so angle with the direction of M1 is 180 minus 143. So M1 is given by 1 by sine 180 minus 143, that is 1.6613, and corresponding value of M1, so corresponding to M1 the VN is, putting the value in the given expression, gamma is 1.4 and M is your 1.66, so we get the value as 1.6667. Similarly the we can find out M2 angle with the M2 of the expansion trailing edge is 20 degrees, so M2 is at 2.90. So putting the value in the expression of VM, so VM2 is at 48.18. So the expansion pan angle is 48 minus 16.67, that is 31.15. So but the answer is given as 48 to 49, so that he may not have suspected this quantity. From that, so answer, right answer is I think 31.5. Next, a strong normal shock wave with pressure ratio 29 across it is traveling into stationary air gamma is equal to 1.4 at T is equal to 280 Kelvin in a straight duct. See figure. The magnitude of velocity of air induced behind the shock wave is dash meter per second round to nearest integer. Gas constant is 287 joule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. The shock wave relation pressure ratio P2 by P1 is equal to 1 plus 2 gamma divided by gamma plus 1 m square minus 1. Density ratio rho 2 by rho 1 gamma plus 1 m square divided by gamma minus 1 m square by 2. So this is your shock wave and this is your velocity imparted by the shock wave, and this, the shock wave has not reached here, so that is stationary, okay, and it is done. So as the pressure ratio is 29, so P2 by P1 is your 29. So putting the value here, we can find out M comes out as 5. Okay, so corresponding to M, the density ratio we can also find out. Okay, putting here M, so density ratio is your 5. Okay. Just putting the values we have find out. Now we can apply continuity division. So this portion has velocity up and this portion has velocity 0 because it is stationary, and the shock has velocity w. The velocity of shock can be determined like this: m is equal to w by gamma rt. M we have found out 5, and temperature is your 280. So w comes out as 1677.08 meter per second. So now we can apply continuity equation here. So as this portion has relative velocity of w with respect to this portion, sorry, relative velocity of w with respect to the stationary, so rho 1 into w is the mass flow rate, and this portion has relative velocity as compared to shock wave is W minus UP, that is W minus UP. So UP comes out from this by putting the value. UP comes out as 1341.66 meters. Just using a relative velocity. Here W is moving like this, so it is stationary, so that's why the relative velocity is W, and here the fluid is moving in this direction and W is also moving in this direction. So relative velocity W minus UP, so weight is equal to W, answer is 1341.66 meters.